Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I am your host, Susan Jo Philip, and these are the major news stories of the day. We begin with an upsetting news from the US. 22 killed and dozens wounded in mass shootings at multiple locations in Maine. Israel mounts new sortie into Gaza, hints there may be several invasions. Enforcement Directorate raids Rajasthan Congress chief in money laundering case related to exam paper leak matter. Delhi court sets hearing for sentencing in Soumya Vishwanathan's murder case for November 7th. Kerala government requests High Court to limit Enforcement Directorate probe only to Karuvanur Bank. Let's get into the details. At least 22 people were killed and 50 to 60 wounded on Wednesday in mass shooting at multiple locations, including a bowling alley and a bar at Lewiston, Maine, NBC News reported, citing a Lewiston police source. The Lewiston Police Department on Facebook identified a person of interest in the mass shooting at the bar and bowling alley as Robert Card, 40, saying he should be considered armed and dangerous. Police earlier posted three photographs of an unidentified suspect pointing what appeared to be a semi-automatic rifle in addition to a picture of a white SUV, asking the public for help in identifying either. The police also posted pictures of the suspect, a bearded man in a brown hoodie jacket and jeans, holding a rifle in the firing position. Israel said its ground forces had pushed into Gaza overnight to attack Hamas targets, as Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said it was preparing for a ground invasion that could be one of several. "I will not elaborate on when, how, or how many," he said in a televised update to citizens on Wednesday evening. The besieged Palestinian enclave is already reeling from almost 3 weeks of Israeli bombardment, which was triggered by a mass killing spree in southern Israel by the Iranian-backed Hamas militants who ran Gaza. Hamas has threatened to kill some of the more than 200 hostages it brought back to Gaza, of whom Israel says more than half hold foreign passports from 25 countries. The Enforcement Directorate on Thursday raided the premises of Rajasthan Congress President Govind Singh Dotasra and party candidate from Mahua Assembly seat as part of a money laundering investigation into the alleged exam paper leak case in the Paul-bound state, official sources said. The premises of Dotasra, a former minister for school education in Sikar and Jaipur, apart from party candidate from Mahua seat in Dausa, Om Prakash Hutla and some other are being searched, they said. An armed escort of Central Paramilitary Force, CRPF, accompanied the ED teams. Soon after the searches commenced, Dotasra wrote Satyamma Vijayate on X. Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot too posted a message confirming the raids on Dotasra and about a ED summon to his son Vaibhav Gehlot, saying the ED raids are being done every day in the state as the BJP does not want that Congress party's guarantees reach the women, farmers and the poor. A Delhi court on Thursday posted the hearing for arguments on the quantum of sentence against 5 individuals convicted in the 2008 murder case of TV journalist Soumya Vishwanathan for November 7. On October 18, the court had convicted 4 accused under the Maharashtra Control of Organized Crime Act, MCOCA, provisions and 1 for receiving stolen property. Additional Sessions Judge Ravindra Kumar Pandey of Saket Courts took note of the fact that certain documents, including the pre-sentencing report by the probationary officer as well as the affidavits of the 5 convicts, had not yet been filed. The Registrar of Cooperatives on Thursday approached the High Court seeking a directive that would limit the Directorate of Enforcement's investigation to Karuvanur Service Cooperative Bank. The petitioner also requested that the ED summons against him be quashed. The petition stated that the court must intervene and stop the probe from spreading to the entire cooperative sector. The petition was filed by a senior government counsel on the legal advice of the Advocate General. The petitioner also sought to issue an instruction to the central agency to ensure that the documents produced when summoning officials for interrogation are preserved. And that brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Stories, hosted by me, Susan Jo Philip. Daily News Stories podcast is produced by Vishnu Muralidharan with technical support from Idea Brew Studios. Follow www.onmanorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.